With good news for today from Baptist Press, I'm Brandon Porter. A Tennessee disaster relief team is taking to the skies to assist those needing help. The Nolachucky Baptist Association Disaster Relief in East Tennessee near Kingsport says they're the first DR team to use a drone in their relief work. So far, the drone has been used in Waverly, Tennessee to help determine the source of flooding that greatly affected the city in West Tennessee. It was also used to assess areas that were in need of debris removal and chainsaw work. Brandon Ramsey is a licensed drone pilot. He serves as the primary pilot for the team. He said the drone allows the team to know what equipment is needed and can cover an area in minutes that would take a team several hours to cover on foot. Sam Porter, National Director of Disaster Relief for SIN Relief, is encouraged by the drone usage and hopes DR teams will follow the Nolachucky team's lead. Teams are important everywhere we look. When we come back, we'll learn about some key characteristics that make for a successful team. Stay with us.
Good news for today is made possible through our friends at the Voice of the Martyrs, a nonprofit organization that serves persecuted Christians around the world. Founded in 1967 by Richard and Sabina Wormbrand, VOM is dedicated to inspiring believers to deepen their commitment to Christ and to fulfill His great commission, no matter the cost. Find out more and sign up for their free monthly magazine at vom.org/goodnews.
Thanks for listening to Good News for Today. I'm Brandon Porter. Teams are more than just a group of players trying to move the ball down the field. Effective teams can be found in offices, schools, and according to one Alabama Baptist leader, in churches. George Yates, a church health specialist, says churches can expect productive teams when these four characteristics are present. The first is that the purpose of the team is clear. What is this team trying to accomplish is a great question to ask. The second is that the team has clear goals and expectations. The third is that the team has open and continual communication. The fourth is that the team celebrates its achievements. You can read the entire article by George Yates, as well as lots of other good articles, at baptistpress.com. Subscribe to Good News for Today wherever you listen to podcasts. From Baptist Press, I'm Brandon Porter.